So at Wisconsin Metal Parts, we've got the opportunity to laser cut, CNC punch, or go into our high production stamping machines. One of the questions we get asked a lot, when do you go with fabrication, laser cutting, CNC punching, and when do you go to a stamping die? So here's a good example showing the differences between fabrication and stamping. This particular part, customer came to us and they weren't quite sure on their design yet, but their sales department wanted to get these out as fast as they could out into the market. So we had about 7 different iterations that we did during the prototyping to get to a final design. During that time, what we went to was to go to our fab department, run these in our fiber lasers, and then do the forming using our brake press. So every time the customer came back with a different prototype that they wanted to try, what we would end up doing is just adjusting the program in the laser and then go back to forming them in the brake. That worked out very well, no additional tooling costs, no changes needed to be made. And then when every time we ran 50 parts, they cost about $12 a piece for their prototyping. And then once the customer finally decided on their final design and we were started to build the production tooling, we ran in conjunction in our fabrication department while the tool was being built for our stamping department here. And those parts at 10,000 pieces cost about $2 a piece for us to make using the laser and brake. Now once we got to building our tool cost about $15,000 to run this progressively, and our parts, we got them to about 44 cents a piece. So in this case, that 10,000 piece mark really worked out well, where that was about the tipping point where the tooling made sense. Now we knew that this customer was going to be running higher volumes, 100,000 or more a year for multiple years, so the ROI was very simple on this one and it made a lot of sense. Once the tool was built and we got up to that 100,000 piece range, then we started running parts for closer to 30 cents. So it definitely paid off for the customer doing it that way. But it's a good illustration showing you what fab costs, what stamping costs, and when we would have crossed over to the other department. So here's another example. This part was for a customer that's in the automotive industry, and it's actually a slider for a sunroof in a car. So this one would make it a little more challenging to run in a fabrication setting because of the tight tolerances and the size of the part and how intricate our forms are. So in this case, we probably would have went with some kind of soft tooling if they wanted to do lower volumes or prototypes. Now this was a very high volume part where we're running around 180,000 pieces a year. So again, looking to a stamping die would have been the route to go. This is the tool that we actually built to run this part, and this is a 21 station tool. So it's a bit more involved than what we did for that last project. So now you're looking at probably a $70,000, $75,000 tool, but that tool will get this part down to around 30 cents or maybe a little bit less. So it'll pay for itself when you're running that high volume. So the fabrication route, there's a lot of pros that go with that. One is you can get into it for low or no tooling costs, depending on what we need in order to make your part. We can also run cost effectively very low volumes versus having to build a stamping die. We can make changes very easily. So if something changes in your design, oftentimes it's just a change in a program rather than having to modify tooling. And we can also get things done very quickly because we don't have to wait around for tooling to be built. Now on the con side of that, as volumes start to go up, it's not always the most cost-effective way to go about it. So you really need to look at what are your future volumes going to be and where would that tipping point be where the tooling would make sense. So when we look at the pros that come with stamping, so we have much more efficiency running when we're running higher volumes. So that'll translate into lower costs overall for your part. We also are able to use material more efficiently because we're running coil stock and we can nest parts usually better than what you can do into a sheet of material. And we also have more consistency when we're running in a die versus trying to do bending in a brake press. So your quality control is usually much better when you're running in a stamping die. Now on the flip side of that, the cons that come with stamping, you're going to have tooling costs And quite often they can be very expensive depending on what quality of tool you need built in order to run your parts. That comes into what's your volume going to be and how complicated is your part. The other thing is lead time. Typically a die build can be anywhere from 8 to 12 weeks depending on the complexity of the part. And we also have, if there's any changes to your designs, that's going to cause a die change, which also will increase costs for you as well. So if you'd like to review your next project, get us involved early and we'll help you pick out the best options and spend your money wisely. Visit us at our website, wisconsinmetalparts.com. And remember, at Wisconsin Metal Parts, we welcome challenges.